tall task to try and implement. That relies very heavily on the visiting public to witness some behavior, some conduct that speaks to that, and be willing to reach out and say, you know, hey, Sheriff's Department, I've got some concerns. There's a group out here that seems to be a bit out of control. Can you come by and, you know, maybe pass a couple words of wisdom to them?
Yeah, well, it's not the drug, it's the behavior.
It's the behavior, yeah.
So, that's the usual conundrum.
Sure, and likely the two very well likely go hand in hand. You know, not all the time, but, you know, statistically speaking, I would imagine the two go hand in hand.
I would like to add to that. I think maybe a better idea would be put that the alcohol is to stay in the pavilion areas, because what I see moving forward with ball fields, and people start to use these ball fields more and more, we don't need parents sitting on the bleachers watching their kids playing ball, drinking a beer. So I don't see anything wrong with saying in the pavilion area only, don't be taking your beers out to the ball fields or down to the disc golf course, or if you're going to consume alcohol.
Pavilion area only. That's where receptacles are at. That's where a structure is at for, you know, seating and for organizing and gathering.
And that will just take care of future issues with these ball fields, with this ball field.
Wouldn't having the behaviors that aren't allowed also take care of that, if you're just trying to target the behaviors? I mean, has there been any issues with alcohol-related?
Not that.
Boisterous?
Well, not that's been reported, but I think the overriding, I guess, conundrum, to use a Tom Tissue word, is that we don't have...
Well, then we could have multiple cases, in which case it would be conundrum.
Yes. Is that... While there may not be any documented history of that being an issue, you know, it, because we don't have the resources to monitor it ourselves, that we then have to rely on the public and the visitors to, when they see that, and it's outside of a posted area that says the pavilion area is where alcohol is to be contained and consumed only, and then if... Again, we're relying on a visitor who sees, knows that sign exists. What's that?
Because they feel threatened?
I don't know if it'd be threatened or if it's just, you know, behavior that's, you know, because everybody has a right to enjoy the park as they see fit. And if somebody is here causing that level of discomfort for any reason in any capacity, they should feel comfortable enough to know that, A, the ordinance exists that speaks to where the alcohol should be. And if there's somebody sitting in a stand watching a game, or if you happen to see somebody going down the disc golf course and they've got a six-pack in tow, that you feel comfortable reaching out to the local sheriff's department and say, hey, sheriff's department, I just saw there's an ordinance here, there's a posting that says no alcohol in the disc golf course. A guy just walked down the six-pack, and I just, for whatever that's worth, that's the only recourse we're going to have.
So if the rule says no unruly behavior, why wouldn't that give them the same confidence to call the police? Why wouldn't anyone feel comfortable talking to police at any time?
Well, it's kind of like the you know, what Mary Beth said about the stance of bleachers at the ball field. It's just, there's certain reasons why we encourage youth to play, you know, youth baseball, and having people sitting in the stands filling beer while the kids are playing the game, somehow exactly we find the right words for it, but it just doesn't seem like the kind of behavior that we really want to encourage. Plus, you know, and after a couple of years, people start liking the umpire's calls. Less. I mean, I remember when my kids were playing in Little League, there was already quite a bit of, you know, completely sober but obnoxious behavior on the part of people in the stands.
A rule about drinking during kids' games? I've read that somewhere too.
Well,
I read something about alcohol.
We're trying to publish a new set of rules here.
Exactly, but there's already a rule that says there's no drinking during t-ball and kids' games. Then
I don't think that we're in any way diminishing that or veering too far away from it by just identifying the location of the acceptable location of alcohol consumption, so that it's not seen to be that, hey, if I behave myself, I can go ahead and have a beer in the stands. We don't want to communicate So the only way to do that without splicing 1,000 different hairs about 1,000 different scenarios or circumstances, it would seem to make sense to me that we identify a central location where it is acceptable, and then we have the best opportunity to police it from that central location. If it veers from that, then we have the hopes of the visiting public that's there to say, isn't beer supposed to be over there? Now, human nature isn't combative or confrontational in its core initially, so that's, you know, when I say that, those carry negative connotation with them. They're not adversarial, they're not, they don't approach people. Human nature is not to approach someone to put their conduct in check.
That's why they call police and
right.
For a third party.
Right.
They want to know.
But if there's no specific wording to where that's allowed, then it becomes a gray area. Too many gray areas become a cloud. And that cloud is what we're trying to
dust away. You're more worried about the behavior rather than the activity. And if you're trying to target behavior, then I think those should target the behavior.
Well, it's not just about the behavior, though.
No.
For me, it's somebody having the latitude to take a beer up into the stands. Their kid's not playing Little League. Their neighbor, whatever, just going to come down and watch the game. If we don't put this kind of verbiage in here, they're free to take their beer and go sit up in the stands. They're not part of the league. There's nothing to stop that.
There's already a rule about the kids' games and alcohol.
But that even if there is, let's say there is a rule that speaks to the Little League games in the field, does it speak to the rest of the park, the totality of the park? It likely doesn't. So what we need to do is take that option away by posting an ordinance, by posting, you know, verbiage that says consumption of alcohol is in this area of the pavilion only.
So what's
that doesn't speak to the conduct that we're talking about. We're talking about two mutually exclusive items.
What's special about the pavilion being next to the children's playground that's different than the stands next to the people?
Yeah, completely right.
Why are we limiting it?
Right, because we can't pick the seventh oak tree with the brown leaves or the fourth maple with the white bark, because we have to pick somewhere that's central and has the accommodations to account for.
How about this? It's allowed everywhere except the ball diamond and the bleachers. Like it is now, apparently.
Yeah, again, we'll all be able to, you know, once we try to get to the proper words, be able to accept or deny or decline, you know, as a group of five, you know, what word we want to use, and, you know, it'll be carried as such with each of our own input by majority vote.
So, Steve, if I understand your point correctly, you think it's important to make sure that people understand it's okay to drink beer under this golf course? Is that what you're, where you're coming from?
No, I just don't. So there hasn't been any issues currently, and I feel pretty sure there's already a rule on the books about the, and so now I don't see what the difference is between someone drinking in the pavilion right next to the playground, if it's a children decency thing. I don't see the difference between them having drinking at the beach or in the pavilion. I don't see the difference.
Okay. So in order to narrow this down, the items that are on here are good, aside from the separate discussion we're having about alcohol. These items that exist here in the form that they're in are acceptable. And the one topic that we're trying to dissect is the alcohol, correct?
Alcoholism. Nominally prohibited in the state park. There's got to be a reason for that. And I think the reason is, speaking broadly, it increases the risks associated with the kind of recreational activities people engage in the park, and also the acceptability of their behavior in a situation which is usually oriented towards family activities.
So we have wording that speaks to no loud or boisterous conduct already as it pertains to what we're talking about in the context of alcohol. So that exists. It says here no loud or boisterous, you know, conduct. If, again, we're relying on the public police, if you will, to bear witness to that conduct and be willing to reach out to an authority of the sheriff department and say, there's a group here, a couple, two or three or five, that are crazy obnoxious, can come have a conversation with alcohol there or not. We have the wording that speaks to loud or boisterous conduct.
Well, I'd like to ask the disc golfers here, is it safe to play disc golf when you're inebriated?
I don't know, I'm not a drinker. I've seen inebriated disc golfers, I've never seen a disc golf injury on a course.
That's, the answer is funny in the ways I can to begin with.
Right.
Well, it's based on your observations for one thing.
What else should I base it on?
Have we seen people out there as disc golfers drink a little too much at times? Yes.
We have had complaints from neighbors.
Sure, I've played with people that drink too much. You know, it's rare.
Yeah.
But it does happen. Anytime you get with drinkers, they tend to over-invite sometimes.
I can't argue with that.
Well, like I say, I'm not a drinker. I never have been. I don't.
But generally speaking, I mean, when you're dealing with a sport where the implements are in fact capable of causing injury, it would seem prudent to follow your rule and stay away from the hooch while you're out there.
I just don't have any interest in drinking, period.
Well, that's laudatory for sure, yeah, but we're talking about.
I would say disc golfers tend to, their scores tend to elevate more so than their recklessness of causing anybody injured. Instead of getting a three on a hole, they start getting fives and sixes.
Yeah. Well,
this golfer isn't going to tolerate getting hit by a disc by a drunk.
No.
Well,
they're not going to tolerate it.
There are other people out there in the park besides disc golfers.
True.
No one would tolerate it, and it's not tolerable behavior.
But people are going to play disc golf whether they can drink out there or not.
Sure.
So I don't think it's necessary to allow the drinking out there. I mean, they're going to play disc golf. They're playing disc golf. They're not there to drink. They're there to play disc golf.
I mean, some of them are.
Well, but, I mean.
And the reality of it, we're not going to be able to weed out every bad egg out of, you know, this park or any park under our control. Just, that's not real. We're never going to be able to do that. So what we have to do is be able to put enough of a blanket policy in place that speaks to what our core values are for the intent of the park, and to some degree hope that there are enough citizen cops interested in maintaining that order to the point of involving themselves to reach out to an authority that says, hey, I see this conduct. So taking that element out of it, the question then